In this video, I'm going to show you how to enable custom thumbnails on your YouTube channel. This is a really important feature to get access to, because if you can't upload custom thumbnails, then you're going to have to use screenshots from your video, and these are always terrible and are going to perform really badly for you, which means you're going to get really low click-through rates. And if you have low click-through rates, no one's going to actually see your videos. And all the time you spend producing your videos is going to be completely wasted, because if no one clicks on your video, then no one watches your video. So let's get custom thumbnails enabled for you so you can get more clicks and get more views and grow your YouTube channel. So let's jump into YouTube Studio. Let me show you the easy way to enable custom thumbnails. So the first thing you need to do is to check if you have access to custom thumbnails. And you can do this by heading into your content and clicking on the pencil icon to edit a video. And then below your video description, you will see we have our thumbnail section here. And we've already uploaded a thumbnail, but if it's a new video, it'll be upload a thumbnail, or you can start an A/B test for your thumbnails. So as a bonus for those of you that watch this video all the way to the end, I'll take you through how to set up an A/B test for your YouTube thumbnails so that you can increase your click-through rate, get more views, and grow your YouTube channel faster so that we can get you monetized quicker. And that's what we're all about on this channel, helping you monetize your YouTube channel. But before we get into all of that, let's go back to step one and get custom thumbnails enabled for you. So to get access to the custom thumbnails, we have to go back to the YouTube Studio. We're going to go to settings, and then we're going to select channel and then feature eligibility. And what you need to do is get your YouTube channel account verified so that you get access to the custom thumbnails. Now, you not only get access to the custom thumbnails, but you get access to live streaming, and you also get access to be able to upload videos longer than 15 minutes. And both these features are great ways for you to reach a new audience, grow your channel faster, and start monetizing your YouTube channel. But we're getting ahead of ourselves again. Let's just get you verified. So you can see we have the green tick here. Our channel is verified. And we check that by seeing that we can upload thumbnails. If you can't upload thumbnails in that first check that we did, if you click on it, it's going to bring you across here and start the verification process. So we have a channel that we have verified recently for our YouTube premium community, where we help YouTubers monetize their channels. So I'm going to show you this verification process so you can see the steps that you need to take in order to get verified. So this is what your channel should look like if you are not verified. You will have your standard features enabled, but the intermediate features, you will just have a gray illegible here. And advanced features will also have that gray illegible. Don't worry about these advanced features just yet. We'll get to that later. The intermediate features, though, that's what is going to give us access to those custom thumbnails. So let's focus on that. If you hit that drop down, you'll see there's a white button that says verify phone number. Now, you need to use a phone number to verify your YouTube channel. And this is mainly to stop bots and spam accounts creating YouTube channels without a human being attached to them. So by verifying, all you're telling YouTube is, hey, I'm a human being and I'm creating this YouTube channel and I'm going to get monetized soon. So it's important for them to know that you are a real human being. So this process does feel a little bit long, but it's worth doing. I promise you, you need to get access to custom thumbnails to grow your YouTube channel. So the step one of one, once you click on that verify phone number, you have an option here. They can text you the verification code, or they can call you with an automated voice message. Now, this is up to you. You don't actually have to talk to anyone. If you select the call me option, they just read you the 6-digit code that you need to verify your YouTube account. So it's not a bad way to go. Before you do this, and before you select your country and enter your phone number, check that you are verifying the right YouTube account. A lot of you I know have created 2-3 different YouTube accounts, and you end up verifying the wrong one, and there's a limit to the number of channels that you can verify for your phone number. You're only allowed to verify 2. So just check that profile picture. So you can see we have our A-team profile picture, which is our premium YouTube community that we have, where we help people monetize their YouTube channels. And this is where all our live recordings go every single week for them to check back on what we've learned and what we've gone through. Next, you just need to select the country that you're in and then enter your phone number. You don't have to put the area code in there. You can just put your normal phone number. As long as you have the right country there, YouTube will work out what your country code is. And then you can select that next button. And then in step 2 of 2, you need to enter the 6-digit code that they send you. Don't enter the 6-digit code that I have here. That's to verify this channel, and it won't work for you. You need your unique code to make sure that they can verify who you are and that you're human creating the channel. So enter that 6-digit code. Once you do, you can click that blue submit button. And once it goes through, you will get that green tick. Now, a lot of people get stuck in this process and they need help troubleshooting. How do I actually get this channel verified? Sometimes the networks don't get your message through to you in time and then you can't verify it. So what I say to people who are battling with this is come back in 10 minutes, try again. If it doesn't work, try the next day. We don't want to delay starting your YouTube channel, but you do need to get verified before you start publishing videos. Otherwise, those videos are going to flop because you're not going to get a lot of clicks. So if you do get stuck along the way, you can leave me a comment down below and I'll be happy to help you out. Try again in 10 minutes. If it doesn't, try on a different cell phone number to see if it's that carrier or just that specific number that it's not going through. Use a friend or your partner or speak to mom or dad and ask them if you can use their cell phone number and they can then let you know what the code is. But that's probably going to be the 2 or 3 things that you can do if you get stuck. Try again in 10 minutes. Try again the next day. If you're still battling, let me know in the comment section down below and we can chat about your specific issue of getting verified. And then once you do get that green tick, head back and check under channel, under feature eligibility, that you have that green enabled and you have the tick next to your verify phone number. Once you've got all of this sorted out, make sure you go back out. So close this and then go to your content and check that you can upload a thumbnail. So go in here and check that you can upload a thumbnail to your video. Now, for those of you that stuck around all the way to the end, I'm going to give you your bonus now and show you how to set up those A/B tests for your thumbnails. And let me show you why this is such a unique advantage that you can get over your competitors to get more views and get monetized faster. But don't tell anyone else that I'm sharing this with you. So let me show you one of the thumbnail tests that we ran on one of our videos. So you can see our thumbnail test results here. And just to give you a little bit of context, and let me just give you some context, we have 11,000 impressions on this video and a click-through rate of 5.6%. So if you look at the thumbnail test that we ran an ABC test. You can run an AB test, which is 2 thumbnails versus each other, or you can do 3 thumbnails so you can have different versions. And what we were testing here is different color backgrounds. Did different color backgrounds make a difference, and did different color ticks to check who had subscribed to you, did that make a difference? And it did. So our thumbnail number 1 with the blue had a watch time share of 31.7%. Now, what does this actually mean? So YouTube is looking at 2 things in this thumbnail test. They're looking at 1, your click-through rate, so how many people that saw your thumbnail and read your title actually clicked and started watching. And of those people that did start watching, how much watch time did they actually give that video? So how long did they watch in comparison to their competitors, the other 2 thumbnails? So I'll help you interpret this more with these figures. So thumbnail 2 has a 47% watch time share, and thumbnail 3 has a 21% watch time share. So it's going to be divided up to how many clicks they got and then how many minutes the people actually watched that video once they were through there. And it's going to add up all those minutes and then it's going to show the share. So almost half of the watch time minutes that we got were from the 1 thumbnail. So if you divide it by 3, it should be 33% if they're all equal. So this one outperformed by like 15% compared to the other 2, which is massive. It's a huge, huge difference. Normally, these tests are really, really close and hard to look and see a big winner. But you can just tell that more people were captivated and interested by the green background and the green ticks. Then the blue and then the plain old boring was 20%. So the blue did a little bit better, 10%, which is actually 50% better. So the percentages are hard to read, but a 20% to a 30% increase is actually a 50% better performance. And then a 31% to 47%, that's 18 by 30, that's more than 50%. So that's like a 61.4685% increase. Just roughly, like, calculating that in my head. Just a thing about stats on YouTube. Just know that 80% of stats are completely made up. So never take them too seriously. Okay, so for you to set up a thumbnail test, how do you do this? You go into your details here, and on the video, you can then choose to upload a file and then upload tests. So let me show you a good example without a thumbnail on our video. So this is an unlisted video, and here it is. So you can upload your file, you can get auto-generated, which we don't want. That's taking a screenshot from your video. And then there's test and compare. And if you click on that, you'll see you can add two thumbnails, or you can add three thumbnails and then click done. When you do this, when you upload all three, it takes a little bit longer to load. So make sure you wait until the thumbnails have loaded and it takes that overlay off so you know they have all loaded and you can then start the test. If you click done too quickly, then not all the video, all the thumbnails upload, you have to restart the whole test. So that's something I did in the beginning that I don't want you to have to go through, because it takes a lot longer to restart the whole test. Now, if you want to get an advantage to monetize your YouTube channel quicker, inside of our YouTube community, we do these tests before you even start uploading your thumbnails. So before you film and edit your videos, we share thumbnail concepts, we share video ideas, and we give you feedback to tell you that this is a good video idea and thumbnail concept and it's going to do well for you. Or no, you're probably going to waste your time here. Your audience is not interested in this topic and you're probably not going to get a lot of views, not going to help you grow your YouTube channel and get you monetized. So those feedback loops that we can shorten before you even publish a video, before waiting for all the stats coming back, that's really going to accelerate your growth, help you get in front of your new audience, and help you monetize your channel quickly. So if that's something you're interested in, then I'll leave a link for you down below to be able to come and join the community. And we have so many cool free resources inside that community that are going to help you, save you so much time, especially when you first start creating videos. It takes a lot of time to make those videos. So anywhere we can help you make the workflow easier and help you make better videos, it's going to be a massive return on your investment. So looking forward to seeing you inside that YouTube community. And if you got stuck anywhere along the way, drop me a comment and I'll be happy to help you out. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you inside the YouTube community.